Clara Honsinger, top 10 here today. You did some great work pulling that group back. What was kind of going through your mind during that chase?
Well, I mean, it was an effort to catch the people in front of me, but it's also an effort, like, you know, there's girls doing the exact same thing, like 30 meters behind you. So just like, we kind of put that gas on to keep from getting caught. And then the girls up front were sitting up. So I don't know, I was really grateful to have made it, but it did take a lot of energy.
I was earlier, I think this week or something, you talked about Jingle Cross and how you didn't have the result you wanted. I personally think that you showed a lot of mental toughness here today. Do you think that you've grown in that aspect this season?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, part of being a professional is having like those really extraordinary days where you're doing super well, but also, you know, keeping it consistent, keeping every day good, not having like extreme highs and lows. And I've definitely noticed that as my racing, there would be those days where it'd be like extraordinary, but then like every few races there'd be one where it was just like it fell apart. But it's kind of like converged to a level of good consistency that I'm happy with.
Do you think that's what happened today? Because a little bit of a slow start, but you just battled your way back. I mean, it could have gone either way, right? You could have dropped down outside the top 20, or you could have rejoined that lead group.
Yeah. I mean, it's also like just like when you feel things that, like little things that kind of slip away, like being able to not let that overwhelm you, which was how I felt at Jingle Cross. Like, you know, I slid out at one point, and then it was just hard to like get back online. But today it seemed like I was able to get back online.
In that chase, you had Katie Klaus, competitor, probably a friend as well. Were you guys working together to help bring that back?
Yeah. We were coming up the straightaway, and like she was leading around, and so then I came up and kind of like around her, and we made the final push, the catch back on there. And just like, you know, the entire time, like she'd be kind of, I'd see her kind of sitting up a little bit, and I'd be like, let's go. And then I'd do the same thing, and she'd be like, come on, Clara. It was freaking awesome. Really fun, the race with her. I feel like teammates.
Oh, that's good. So you guys got a little teammate action out here racing at Worlds. That's good to hear, huh?
Yeah. I mean, at the end of the race, you're always sprinting to try and catch the next person, but it definitely felt like we were working together a little bit there.
First time I met you was I think Saturday night at Jingle Cross two seasons ago. Now we're here at Worlds. You're in 10th place. How do you feel about how your career is coming along in the season that you had?
This is my last year as a U23. I'm really happy with how it's gone. I'm really happy with last weekend being able to get a World Cup podium. I feel like for my U23 career, I've accomplished a lot that I want. However, I want to take it to the next level as an elite, to kind of move out of the development and do like, I don't know, take it to the next level, to be an elite.
And when you step up to the elites, are you going to go from being Lil Clara to Big Clara, or is it always going to be Lil Clara?
That's not for me to decide.
Great. Well, Clara, congratulations. Great effort here today. It was super fun watching your race.
Thank you.